Anti-scientific attitudes, ranging from mistrust of vaccinations to climate change denial, impose substantial costs on society. These attitudes and beliefs are shaped by a multitude of factors, but to what extent can they be influenced by policy? This paper studies one potential determinant of scientific attitudes that is directly within policymakers' purview: the content of science education in high school. The author focuses on education standards in the US and asks whether students' exposure to evolution theory has a causal impact on their scientific knowledge and life decisions. Evolution forms the foundation of the life sciences and has broad scientific consensus, yet it remains a highly charged topic among the US population. Only 65% agree with the statement that humans have evolved over time, and the teaching of evolution in public schools has been hotly contested since the 1920s. Well into the 21st century, there continues to be substantial variation across states and years in the coverage of evolution in school, and this paper focuses on the portion of that variation attributable to state science education standards. Science standards define the scientific knowledge and skills that students are supposed to master in a given grade. They form the basis for myriad factors affecting students' learning, including local curricula and lesson plans, the content of science textbooks, and the materials tested on statewide standardized exams. A state's standards can be reformed via a majority vote of its Board of Education, and this paper focuses on instances between 2000 and 2009 when a reform either increased or decreased a state's coverage of evolution. Here, the degree to which different standards cover evolution is measured by their evolution score, which ranges from 0 for no coverage to 1 for comprehensive coverage. Now, these reforms, of course, are not random. They reflect changing scientific, religious, or political attitudes in a given state. The argument, however, is that while the occurrence of a reform may not be random, its precise timing in one year versus another is as good as random due to institutional idiosyncrasies. Because reforms are determined by each state's Board of Education, their precise timing depends on multiple factors, including the predetermined timing of elections and the tenure length of board members. But once a reform is enacted, its implementation tends to be swift. Thus, to estimate the causal effect of changes in evolution coverage, the author compares, in a given state, adjacent high school cohorts who were exposed to different science standards due to reform, all while netting out fixed differences between states and cohorts. There are three main findings. First, science standards do affect what students learn about evolution in school. Student-level data from the 12th grade NAEP standardized exam reveals that being exposed to a science standard with an evolution score of 1, compared to one with a score of 0, increases the share of questions on evolution that a student answers correctly by 20%. There is no evidence of any treatment effect in pre-reform years, and immediately after there is a stable and significant change in evolution knowledge. This shows that the content of education standards can foster scientific knowledge in school. What about actual scientific beliefs? Students exposed to evolution may be able to answer relevant exam questions without necessarily being convinced of the theory's correctness. To probe this, the author links the evolution score to data from the General Social Survey, a biennial cross-sectional survey drawn from a nationally representative sample of U.S. adults. He finds that individuals who were exposed to an evolution score of 1 in high school, as opposed to a score of 0, are 57% more likely to believe in evolution in adulthood. This corresponds to a persuasion rate of 79% and indicates that the impact of these reforms persists long after students have left school. Interestingly, the estimated impacts are confined to the topic of evolution. There are no corresponding effects on religiosity or political attitudes. Finally, Beyond its impact on scientific beliefs and attitudes, teaching evolution also affects real-world high-stakes decisions. The paper's third and final finding is that exposure to evolution in high school increases an individual's probability of working in the life sciences in adulthood. Data from the American Community Survey indicate that high school exposure to an evolution score of 1 versus a score of 0 increases the probability of working in the life sciences by 23%, with the overall effect primarily driven by occupations in biology. In absolute terms, the estimated effect corresponds to more than 90,000 workers and demonstrates how science education can help attract future STEM workers. And so, this paper shows that the teaching of evolution affects students' knowledge about evolution, their belief in evolution in adulthood, and their probability of working in the life sciences. A naive linear extrapolation of the estimated effects suggests that if all states were to adopt science standards with an evolution score of 1, evolution belief in the US population would increase by 20% of the sample mean, and the number of adults working in the life sciences would increase by 8%. These results show that school standards can be an influential policy tool for affecting scientific attitudes, and, more broadly, that school instruction matters and can shape students over the long term. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on how the content of education affects students' knowledge, the impact of school curricula reforms, and the determinants of occupational choice.